Lantern Magician, I am Jay, your guide to cut through the hype and actually master your EOS M.
Today we are getting you a stock Canon EOS M turned into a raw shooting beast in under 5 minutes. No forum rabbit holes, no dead links, no outdated guides. And with what some people still call a toy, I have made over 100 grand.
So yeah, it works.
3 years ago, this would have been a 40-minute video. Installing Magic Lantern used to feel like assembling a rocket. Enable this, disable that, restart 5 trillion times and pray. Now, thanks to crop mode and the brilliant work of Bilal and Dan, you can be rolling in under 5 minutes. Firmware check. If your EOS M body came with anything but firmware version 2.02, you must either down or upgrade to that very version or Magic Lantern won't install. But don't worry, I'll walk you through it fast, as well as some associated landmines. 2. SD card reality check. This is raw video, don't cheap out. I recommend at least 128GB SanDisk Extreme Pro, or the camera will drop frames and frustrate you. So even if you're still in the is this for me phase, get a reliable card and save yourself the headache. 3. Download the install asset package from the link in the description containing the build I currently use and recommend. 4. Make sure you got a good and full battery ready to go. Alright, here's our stock EOS M. I'm turning it on. And that's what it looks like. Let's flip through the modes. Here's the auto mode, the manual photo mode, and the video mode. And as mentioned before, the first thing we need to find out is the firmware, and therefore I will press the menu. And if you are lucky, you will find it somewhere in here. But I told you before, there are some landmines. I'm flipping to another mode. That one, the photo mode, manual photo mode, and it's nowhere to be found. So if that's you, let's flip to the auto mode. If that's you, and no matter what you do, you cannot find the firmware information, let me show you how to find it. First, click back into this middle position there, and then this time press the info button. There you'll click on what's called CA. That's basically like a demo mode for demonstration in shops or whatever it used to be. And now click on M for manual. Reboot the camera and turn it on again. And let's click on menu again. And voila, there's your firmware. And we're lucky it's 2.0.2. But if it's not, you have to first change it, connect it to the computer before we can move on. But here we are lucky it's the right firmware. So now let's turn the camera off and take out the card and start with the actual install procedure, and as promised, this will take under 5 minutes. All right, here we go. Let's start the clock. Insert your card in your computer card reader. Click on it, and then if you're on a Mac, you go to your disk utility and whatever equivalent on the PC. And now we are going to format it first, sort of really wipe it clean. So I click on erase. You can name it whatever you want. And make sure it's formatted in a FAT format. It used to be a FAT32, but that's no longer an option. Just make sure it's not a Macintosh format, because then it won't work. Okay, that's how quickly that went. And now we can eject the card. There we go. Put it back in the camera. Make sure, by the way, I said it before, but make sure your battery is charged. And now we go to the menu, to the wrenches, and on wrench number one, format card. And that will format it in the Canon way, you know, how Canon likes its card to be formatted. And what that does is just puts a bunch of folders on there where you'll then find your images. And okay, we're done. Turn the camera off. Put the card back in the computer, like so. And there it is. As you can see, Canon formatting put two folders on there. And on the left is the build that I provided to you. Click on it, open it, and whatever, all the things in there, you just drag on the card and it will take maybe a second to install. And as you can see, it added a bunch of things. And that's it. Eject, take it out again, and put it back in. Close the lid and turn it on. So, and now, make sure we are in the middle position there. Let's click on menu, move back to the firmware menu item there. Camera, not the lens. We don't want to mess with the lens. And now click OK. Update the firmware. No worries. It all should work out automatically. So what you will see in a second is the install process handled all by Magic Lantern. And that took just a couple of seconds, and now it says restart your camera. And that's what we shall do. Turn it on again. And that's it. And it already looks different, but that's like the photo mode. We are not interested in photos, at least I'm not. Flip it into camera mode, and as you can see, once you hold down the trash can button, we're in the Magic Lantern menu, and that looks a whole lot more complex than your standard Canon menu. And that's basically your Magic Lantern software installed. And if you hit record, wow, we're recording raw.
Boom, you've got Magic Lantern.
From here, you are basically sitting in a race car that looks like a hatchback, but it drives like a beast.
That is, if you learn the controls.
If you're here just for plug and play, sandbag the camera now. This is not for shortcut seekers or quick hack tourists. This is for people who want to learn real filmmaking. And here the final checklist of 6 mistakes that can wreck your first attempt. Installing with anything other than firmware 2.02. SD cards that look fast but aren't. Use the recommended one if you're not sure, it's SanDisk Extreme Pro. And if you're on Mac, make sure you format the card in the FAT format. Using an old battery or one that's not fully charged, it will cause random shutdowns mid-install. Skipping the double format, first in PC, then in camera. Pulling the battery during install, obviously don't do this. So, and if ever you wanna uninstall Magic Lantern, this is how to do it. Again, make sure we are in the middle position there. Navigate to the firmware menu item. There it is. Camera, click on it and hit OK. And then it's gonna take literally a minute, which I have sped up for your convenience. That's how fast seconds go in my world. And boom, Magic Lantern is uninstalled. Turn the camera off. Turn it back on again. And Magic Lantern is gone. Let's confirm. Let's go through the Canon stock menu. Everything looks normal there. If I half press the shutter and engage the trash can button, nothing happens. So Magic Lantern has officially been uninstalled.
Now that your EOS M is running Magic Lantern, it's time for you to actually learn how to use it.
And by the way, there's a free printable checklist PDF below if you want all of this on one page. page. In episode 2, I'll walk you through the buttons, the menus, and the overall layout, because no one likes getting stuck in a mystery mid-shoot. So click through to episode 2 EOS M menu walkthrough to learn the control basics.